Ohio. What do you need to bring out the best in you? Well, first thing is definitely honesty. When you leave honesty, when you stay dishonest with yourself and how you feel, what you think, what is happening for you, then it's really time to change that and to turn this into honesty with yourself, because the honesty makes it easier for you that you can just see what's going on, that you can learn to deal with it. And when you learn to deal with what is going on, it's also easier to be your natural self with your talents, with your gifts, with your presence, with your maybe some quirky ways or strange things, your characteristics, all these things that matter to you in a way, but sometimes maybe also seem to be in the way. Honesty is the very essential need for building a better relationship with yourself. Two, accept that you are constantly transforming. Right now, you are transforming. There's a constant transformation happening every moment in your life. And you may not be aware of it, but that is actually a fact. Even scientists know that there's a constant transformation. And also when you have just used your common sense, then you know that actually everything is changing. The cells in your body, the thoughts are changing. New life is being created, formed, shaped into all processes in your body, in the skin, in the brain, in the gut, in the everywhere. So, and in your breath, in oxygen that enters and leaves your body. So there's a continuous transformation happening. When you realize that there's a continuous transformation happening, life becomes more of an opening, an adventure. Then you, once you see that you cannot resist this transformation, you can move with it. You can start to move along with the transformation and surrender or try to discover what this means to you, what it does to you, actually. So transformation is a very good insight to see that is happening right now. Recognize the natural talents that you have. How can you recognize your natural talents? Well, your natural talents that are most genuine, authentic, and part of you are the things that you usually overlook. Once you start to look for something special, it has to be in a certain way. But usually your most natural talents are the things that you just can't stop doing. Like maybe you like very much to play football or cook or help others, take care of animals, something like that. Or make very good coffee. That are your natural talents. They happen during your daily life. They happen right now, not now or right in front of you, wherever you are. So reflect on what it is that you're doing in daily life, what you're good at. Or maybe you don't see that you're good at it, but maybe you could, if you reflect on it, you could discover actually that you are good at it. Four is changing your perception to wanting to know how life works with the mind, to actually experiencing life. Because when you try to understand how life works and you're mostly focused on obtaining knowledge or information about how life works, it usually brings you away from where you are and also from what you actually want, which is to experience life. Experiencing life brings you right to where you are, brings you to your sensations, to what you're feeling, to what you're going through, to connect with your challenges, to reflect on what is going on for you. So experiencing life is a change of mindset, is something that you can practice from the view of trying to know everything, trying to control also what you know. Try to let that go and let it fall back into your actual experience. 5. Accept that you don't have control, but by listening to your heart, you can actually follow your heart's true longings. When you think you're having control in life, then you are all the time out of pace. You're walking not in your natural rhythm of what you're naturally actually good at. That keeps you from being the best version of yourself. That keeps you from growing into your potential. And when you start to connect more to what your heart is telling you, how you're feeling, then things can start to flow more for you, and you surrender more to life, that knowing, well, I don't actually have control. I might have longings, desires, but we never know what is going to happen because you are here living in this very moment. But the signals that your heart is sending you continuously can be a very good reminder of what is truly important for you, what truly matters to you, that your heart knows. Your heart tells you continuously what truly matters to you. 6. Take your feelings serious and your thoughts less. Whatever you're feeling, that is true for you. That is happening. That is the only thing that really matters. Feelings always come first. They're an inherent system of your body-mind dynamics. Feelings always appear immediately, continuously. Then the thoughts come and they start to respond to whatever they think that you're feeling. And a thought is not just a thought. There comes the response to the thought, like an attachment, a judgment, a contracted energy, like, I don't like what I feel. So it always comes after your feelings. But don't take them always seriously, because your feelings are actually the first pure signal that you should take seriously. They can help you to ground yourself, to stay true to yourself, to remember what is it actually that I'm feeling, and to not take this thought so serious and to think, actually, this is important to me. The thoughts, okay, I recognize that they're there, but the feeling, even though maybe scary, confronting, challenging, is here, and I acknowledge it, I recognize it. Once you start to recognize it, you can also become very much more in your power, much more in your strength, by allowing this to just be there. 7. Laugh about yourself and your quirky ways. Learn to relax about not being perfect. Learn to see that you are perfect in your imperfectness, and that you can loosen this idea of perfectness being this perfect image, or having to be different than you are, because then it's never going to be easy for you to come into your strength, to grow into your potential. Relax, surrender to, I am not perfect, everything just appears to be as it is. Naturally, you are a natural in how you are, in how you speak, in how you do, in how you act, even though that is maybe to others funny or weird. Who cares that others perceive you in a different way? It tells everything about somebody else, not about you. So let it go and just be yourself. Surrender to that you are as you are. You are beautiful. Thank you for being here. See you soon.